My dearest friend, I just received your two letters and tape in the mail. They were awaiting me at my old address in the northern part of town. As I read your words, the sun is just beginning to dip upon the hills that border the village, and the sky beams with yellow and violet. Thank you for writing me as you do. As we have shared so much during our time apart, it seems as though our trust is genuine and special. It always makes me feel good to know that there is someone out there who cares about my life. I've just woken from a nap because I spent the whole night on a hoop doing the rumba. I showered and came down to the tiny terrace bar, one of two which flank my building door. The one I've always frequented is filled with families, tiny four-year-old girls in bright pink and purple print cloth, and exquisite 1920s hair bobs scrounging about in the dirt together, while their grandparents expertly let the world go by while their beers glow topaz. Moms with leather jackets, plucked eyebrows, smoking. Older women with sweaters on their shoulders, soothing the inevitably ruffled feathers of the pink-printed dolls. Slick, black-haired men in jeans, sunglasses, and white espadrilles jiggle laughing babies. Inside the two bars, from my outside vantage point, I hear a stereo roar as the Madrid soccer team makes a goal. The other bar is the scary one, filled with the young, harder people who are known as the heavies. Both the men and the women have long feathered hair, tight pants, black shirts, and interesting necklaces in their open button chests, leather jackets, fringed boots. Then, on the other side, are the night brood, the wild ones. Every night they gather and listen to tapes and drink liters of beer with a dog or two, leaning on a fence that faces the garden. Of course, the bar group is more splendid and scruffy in their low-class finery. But the wild children were the first I saw months ago from my fourth-floor window. They gathered like dried leaves in the windy, late winter nights and disappeared before dawn. Their circle kept its back towards me the nights I waited outside for Herman. I watched them, envious, dreaming of the lost boys, wanting to pass the beer bottle around and be accepted into their ring of arrogance and ease with each other. The long hair, the occasional horseplay, the generosity. But then I took a closer look. I guess we'd have little in common. It was more glamorous from four flights up. Favorite character just appeared, a baby about 10 months old, Deborah. Her mother is the only local I've talked to who does not own a bar or a shop. She's often in the hands of Christina and Carlos, the bar owner's kids. They're delightfully bright and extroverted. I've talked with them too. The baby laughs and laughs when I play with her. As she sits on someone's lap, she chews on a pack of Fortunas. You know she's going to be wonderful when she's older. I love you. Your subtlety and irony, even when you're down, is dear to me. I'm sorry you've been in so much pain lately. I'm helpless except to reach across the Atlantic with an embrace. And remember, you make me laugh like no one else can. Leave you now. The sun is almost completely set and places the cafe under the gentle blessing of the night sky. The bartender has just lit the candle on the table, reminding me that I do not know when I shall return to your shores. My life here is full, but I cannot call it home. I miss you every day, but I know that I must be here for now and look for your words to travel across the oceans to rest in my hands. I shall never abandon you in my friendship, and your heart shall always forever remain in mine. I'm not one to make promises, but I know that I'll keep this one. The night has fallen, and I shall walk to my lover's house with memories of us on my every breath. We may drift in time and space, but I never want to imagine us being without each other. May the universe cradle you in her arms, and may the wisteria of dreams hang over your head. Blessings, health, and sweet laughter. I love you, always.